semi-automatic analyzer. Semi-automated analyzer, as the name implies, has partial automation. The initial part of the procedure, that is pipetting of reagent and specimen, mixing and incubation, is carried out by the technician. Rest of the procedure, that is setting of incubation temperature for kinetic determinations, zero setting, photometric readings, result display, automatic printing, and data management and processing is carried out by the analyzer. Chemistries can be programmed into a defined number of channels and can be recalled as and when tests are done. Measuring temperatures are 25, 30, 37 degrees Celsius. Wavelength positioning is automatic once programmed. Instrument automatically sets the wavelength when the operator selects the chemistry to be done. Number of wavelengths usually are 340, 405, 505, 546, 570, 623, and 700 nanometers. Parts of a semi-automatic analyzer. Usually, all semi-automatic analyzers of different makes will have the following main parts. Flow cell with aspiration tube. The flow cell has a tiny window through which the light passes. Screen. Keypad with printer. Waste bottle. And light source or lamp which is located internally. Preparation of analyzer. Check the power supply and make sure it can supply proper voltage for the analyzer. Check if the power cord of the system is properly connected. Check and make sure sufficient printing paper is prepared for the printer. If not, feed more printing paper. Check if the waste tube at the back of the system is connected to the waste bottle or other disposal channels. Check if the waste bottle is full. If yes, empty the waste bottle. Place the power switch to on position. The display will usually show information regarding the instrument model, review software, laboratory name, date and time, which can vary with different instruments. Allow the instrument to equilibrate for 15 minutes. The cell temperature is controlled at 37 degrees Celsius by software. Preventive maintenance. Before beginning the day's work, please follow the manufacturer's instructions for startup and maintenance of your equipment. In this equipment, these are as follows.
Cleaning of the probe with distilled water. Clean the outside of the probe gently with tissue paper and then with distilled water to dislodge any debris that might have collected inside.
Be careful to clean the probe gently, avoiding any bends in the orientation of the probe. Pull out the flow cell gently and check if the window has any dust. If so, clean carefully with a tissue paper and place it back gently. Temperature should be fixed at 37 degrees Celsius and should be achieved within 1 to 2 minutes of switching on the equipment. Vacuum should be maintained at 6.9 plus or minus 1. This is very important for sample aspiration and analysis. If the vacuum is not maintained, immediately switch off the equipment and call the technical support team.
Types of tests in clinical biochemistry: endpoint tests, rate or fixed time tests, kinetic tests. We will discuss one example of the endpoint test in this tutorial, that is, the measurement of glucose by glucose oxidase, peroxidase, that is GOD-POD method. Before proceeding to testing of samples, let us learn about calibration. We will now run the glucose standard as test sample and calculate the calibration factor.
Label two test tubes as standard and blank. Take 1 ml of working reagent in both test tubes. Take 10 microliters of standard with a pipette. Wipe off the excess with a tissue and add it to the standard test tube. Incubate it for 10 minutes in a water bath or incubator at 37 degrees. The kit insert advocates 20 minutes at room temperature as an alternative. The implied temperature here is 25 to 30 degrees. Since it is difficult to maintain this, it would be advisable to do 37 degree incubation. Aspirate the blank test tube, that is the one without the standard. Read the absorbance. Here it is 0.062. Now aspirate the standard test tube. A calibration graph is displayed which depicts absorbance on y-axis and concentration on x-axis. The graph should be linear. The absorbance of the standard is 0.418 for a concentration of 100 mg per deciliter. The equipment derives a calibration factor by dividing the specified value by the standard abs, that is absorbance. Therefore, the calibration factor will be 100 divided by 0.418, which is equal to 238.9.
Till such time that the calibration is not repeated, every test result is derived by multiplying the test absorbance by this factor.
Prepare the control tubes. Take two test tubes labeled as normal and abnormal QC. Add 1 ml of reagent to both and 10 microliters of normal control and 10 microliters of abnormal control to the respective tubes. Run the QCs. The result of the normal QC is 82.1, which is within the specified range of 78.1 to 105.7 mg per deciliter. Document the result. Similarly, run the abnormal QC. The result of the abnormal QC is 248.4, which is within the specified range of 210 to 318 mg per deciliter. Document the result. As all values lie within the range, we can conclude that the analytical system is good and proceed to testing patient samples.
After calibration has been performed and successfully verified using QCs, we move to the actual testing of unknown patient samples.
Glucose is oxidized into a red-colored compound. The intensity of the red-colored compound is proportional to the glucose concentration and is measured at 505 nanometers, which is 490 to 530 nanometers. Reagent preparation. Sometimes reagents are liquids, ready to use. Sometimes reagent preparation is required. Here, the glucose kit contains enzyme reagent, buffer solution, and standard. To prepare the reagent used in this test, dissolve 1 vial of enzyme reagent, which is in a powdered form, in 1 bottle of buffer solution. Dissolve the powder with buffer solution and then pour the entire amount into the buffer solution. Mix gently to make it homogeneous. The prepared working enzyme reagent is stable for at least 2 months at 2 to 8 degrees Celsius. Specimen collection and handling. Use fresh unhemolyzed plasma. The stability of glucose in specimen is reduced by bacterial contamination and by glycolysis. Serum or plasma should be separated from the cells as soon as possible to prevent glycolysis. The best collection tube is the gray fluoride tube that contains glycolysis inhibitors. At room temperature, that is 25 degrees Celsius, a loss of 1 to 2% of total glucose per hour is seen in whole blood samples. Centrifuge at 3000 RPMs for 5 minutes. Arrange in tube racks according to lab ID numbers. Programming the analyzer for glucose testing. The programming of glucose is done as per the programming sheet accompanied with the kit. In this machine, go to the display screen and key in the following. From mode menu, select single standard mode, which is endpoint reaction. Select primary filter at wavelength 505 nanometers, green filter. Incubation temperature 37 degrees Celsius. Incubation time is 10 minutes in incubator or water bath. Some machines may have internal incubators, then program the incubation time for 10 minutes. Sample volume, 10 microliters.
Reagent volume at 1 ml.
Light path, 1 cm. For the standard, feed the value specified on the kit, insert. Here it is 100 mg percentage. Linearity, 500 mg percentage. Unit, mg percentage. Test procedure. As blank reagent and standard have already been run to get the calibration factor and the QC has been verified, we are now to run the test sample. Add 10 microliters of test sample to 1 ml of reagent. Incubate at 37 degrees Celsius for 20 minutes or as recommended by the manufacturer. take the absorbance reading on the analyzer. Note: clean the dust, moisture on tubes before they are used. Do not read tubes containing bubbles or condensation. Use the same type and size of tube for the blank and samples. Hemolysis, icterus or lipemia in the samples may lead to unreliable test results. Effluent from the equipment should be treated with 10% hypochlorite for a minimum contact time of 30 minutes before discarding. Linearity. As we said earlier, the result for each analyte is valid for certain linearity only. In this case, it is 500 mg per dl. If the concentration of the analyte is more than the linearity, the equipment will flag in some way. This equipment is flagging both the absorbance as well as concentration. Dilute the sample with normal saline, 1 part sample and 4 parts normal saline. Now take 10 microliters of this diluted sample and mix with 1 ml of reagent and run. The reading now is 230.2 mg per dl. Multiply this by dilution factor, that is 5, as the dilution of sample was 1 part sample and 4 parts normal saline, to get the final value. So here the patient value for glucose is 230.2 multiplied by 5, which is equal to 1152 mg per deciliter.
Programming of individual analyte has been discussed in the video on general principles of biochemistry. Now, we will discuss about equipment calibration.
Parts of this equipment that need calibration can be: the peristaltic tubes can grow weak and lose their elasticity over time. The pump that aspirates may go weak and may need readjustment. The lamp inside has a specified life, generally for 2000 hours. If you are using your equipment for 4 hours a day, the lamp will need replacement in 500 days, which is less than 2 years. The cuvette or the flow cell will get dirty and will need to be cleaned or replaced. The filters also have a specified life and also require change.